Hi, I'm State Representative Drew Stokesberry from Auburn. I've been getting a lot of questions about the state budget lately, and since I have the privilege of sitting on both the House Finance and House Appropriations Committees, I thought I'd answer some of those questions in a segment that I'm calling the 1 Minute Budget Breakdown. Even though state revenue is growing by $3 billion under current law, Democrats have proposed a series of 10 new tax increases that would raise another $1.5 billion. One of them, called the Main Street Tax, is actually a significant expansion of the sales tax. If you give me a minute, I'll give you the breakdown. Have you ever noticed that you pay sales tax on some online purchases but not others? The reason involves a quick lesson in tax law, but luckily I'm a tax attorney. The US Constitution says only Congress can regulate interstate commerce. In the 1992 case of Quill v. North Dakota, the Supreme Court said that means a state can't tax sales by an out-of-state company unless that company has a physical presence in the state. Washington follows that rule. It's why you pay sales tax at Amazon, whose corporate headquarters are here, and Nordstrom, which has stores here. But you're not taxed on purchases from eBay, Etsy, or L.L. Bean, since those companies don't have a store or office here. Now Democrats want to start charging sales tax on everything you buy online, even if the seller lacks a physical presence here. That will take money out of your wallet. And because this violates the Constitution and Supreme Court case law, the state would be sued and have to pay lawyers even more of your tax dollars to defend itself in court. The state of Illinois tried something like this just a few years ago, and it was recently struck down as illegal. That's why the Main Street tax is unfair, and I don't think it's the right direction for Washington State. I'm State Representative Drew Stokesberry. Check back soon for the next 1 Minute Budget Breakdown.